Hi, this is Vaughn at Spirit of Health. Rest and sleep while fasting. So some of this might seem obvious, but I think it needs to be shared, and hopefully I can give you some extra little tips when it comes to this important aspect of fasting. Now, a lot of this depends on the type of fast you're going to do. Obviously, a deep extended water fast is different than a 21-day Daniel fast, for example. So you need to prepare for a fast, I think, regardless, but especially if you're gonna go deep. If you're gonna juice fast, water fast, dry fast, I really encourage taking time off of work, maybe even going to a secluded location that you can rest. If you plan to just kind of work your normal schedule, I don't see wisdom in that. And, you know, I'm not saying that that doesn't happen and people can't do that. And of course the Lord is with you and you can encounter the Lord and you can still be fasting and working. But I'm just saying, for multiple reasons, not only to just be still with God and hear from Him, and to rest our bodies. Rest is so important. We are so worn out. I mean, I am an example of that. I mean, it's our culture. We burn it at both ends, so to speak, sun up to sundown. We're a million miles an hour. It's hard to find time to rest and to pray and to do the basic thing. So this is the time. Fasting is the time to rest, to take chunks of your schedule out that you would just rest. Now, that rest might be with your family. It might be somewhere in nature. It might be just in your private prayer closet and you're just spending more time in prayer in a prayer room or in church. So just whatever that looks like for you, I'm really encouraging you to rest. And again, it's because partially we need to reset our bodies. We need to heal our bodies. If you've heard of the nervous system, sympathetic, parasympathetic. Parasympathetic nervous system is the rest, heal, relax, heal portion of the nervous system. And that's the place we need to be for healing, for relaxation, for deep sleep. Now, some tips if you're having issues with sleep. I've had issues when I water fast sometimes. I have a hard time sleeping. I have a hard time turning things off and going to sleep, turning my mind off. So just a couple of things that can help you with that if you wanted to try them. Magnesium is fantastic. I like magnesium oil the best. I use one called Health and Wisdom, and I recommend magnesium oil foot soaks. And the nice thing with that is you get a little foot tub, some warm water, just enough to cover your toes, and put about a quarter cup of that magnesium oil in there and soak your feet for 15, 20 minutes before bed. Calms and relaxes everything down. It's an electrolyte mineral your body and your nervous system needs. We burn magnesium from the stress and the busyness of life. So it's really good at calming you down, bringing that busy brain down a little bit. So I'd really try the magnesium oil. Holy basil. I mean, I've been promoting holy basil for all 10 years I've been doing this. I love holy basil. Get it in a tincture form. We have a couple different ones, Cedar Bear or Oregon's Wild Harvest. But holy basil was actually used for thousands of years to put people in a prayer meditative state. So especially when fasting, what better time to do holy basil to just bring that nervous system down, give you that piece of calm, relaxation, that nice feeling. So great anytime during the day. Doesn't make you sleepy or drowsy, but it's great at night before bed as well. I have a couple of formulas I really like that are herbal formulas that can help you to sleep. One is called Adrenal Restore PM. And so if you're familiar with the adrenal glands, it's kind of like our battery pack, our hormones, our energy source, and they're pretty depleted, they're pretty wiped out. So the Adrenal Restore PM has some calming, relaxing, adrenal balancing herbs. And man, Mike created that formula. It's brilliant. It's brilliant. I mean, my wife loves it. I have so many people that really, really love the Adrenal Restore PM. So check that out. It's in our bulk section. And if you just want to drink a tea, get our relaxation tea. Basic calming, what are called nervine herbs that just calm and relax the nervous system and just make you feel warm and cozy and relaxed before bed. So just some type of herbal support. Magnesium, basic things to calm you, to relax you. In our children's room, we are always playing sounds. So, you know, like ocean waves or crickets or the thunderstorm. There's even one that's like a crackling fire. So that's really fun. And, you know, those natural things can help calm you and relax you. Getting an earthing mat or an earthing sheet, if you've heard of those, it grounds you, connects you to the earth, and makes you feel very calm and relaxed. So there's a whole lot of things that can help you calm down, help you relax. And I encourage you to try some of those things. But really, one of the most important things is that you would just actually carve time out of your schedule to heal your body, to hear from the Lord. And, you know, that might mean walking in nature. I mean, I would be happy just sitting by a stream with my feet in the water. I mean, that would be just like such a peaceful, amazing experience, because in our world, living in cities, sometimes just those simple things are hard to do. So be intentional. Maybe that's just the key here. It's like, we're so busy flying by every minute of the day, trying to get so many things done. Like, be thoughtful of what you're about to undertake in this fast. Be mindful, be thoughtful, prepare, talk to your family, decide some things that you can do to get away. Every time I do any kind of extended fast, I might not do it the whole time, but I will take at least a chunk of time, and I will get in the woods, in the mountains, in a cabin. I connect with God through nature. That's my happy place. I could easily just fall asleep on the forest floor. I mean, I just, you know, we were designed to sit in a garden with God and just be at peace, right? So there's just something special about that. So I hope this helps a little bit. I hope it gives you some tips. I hope you're motivated to rest and relax, to be intentional. Maybe use some of those tips if you start having issues or trouble with your sleep. Those are good tips. Let me just, one more popped into my head that can help adults, but I've seen it help a lot of children as well. People have liver issues and liver congestion, and while you're fasting, you might have some liver stuff start to come up as your body's detoxifying, and that can affect sleep, especially if you're waking up 1 to 3 a.m. That could be a liver thing. And so glutathione is an antioxidant. You can buy a bottle of glutathione in a pump spray. We use one by a company called Quicksilver. For children, whew, hallelujah. I mean, we have seen so many children, in my own included, sleeping through the night when they get on glutathione. I have so many parents thanking me for this little tip to get their children to sleep through the night, because sleep's pretty precious when you're a parent, for the children and for you. So try the glutathione before bed. We have another one that's in a tube by Research Nutritionals. It's like a watermelon flavor, and the kids would love it. It's like candy. It tastes so good. So that's just a little tip for your sleep as well. And so that's it. I hope those ideas help, and I hope you take the time to rest, heal, repair, connect to nature, and connect to God while you're fasting, while you're healing.